I think the principles of prudent healthcare are important to primary care because they underpin a lot of the change that we're trying to achieve. So, for example, do no harm. Well, there's a huge safety agenda in primary care about making care as safe as it possibly can in terms of prescribing and the treatment that we offer and making sure that we are measuring that safety. And also in terms of service redesign, the principle about only doing what you should do is an important one because in primary care we're trying to move to a much more multidisciplinary way of working. I would explain prudent healthcare by saying it's really sort of a common sense approach. It's how you might manage your own life. You look at doing the minimum that you need to do, sort of spending the least that you need to do and making sure that you and your family were as safe as possible and applying that to the health service. It's a philosophy, I think, not a set of actions. The challenges in primary care are big, really, in terms of issues around workforce and sort of difficulty recruiting in certain areas, such as GPs, but also a difficulty in transitioning to a new model that makes a much better use of the workforce. So, for example, different practitioners taking on new roles, pharmacists doing more prescribing and advanced nurse practitioners taking on new roles and perhaps paramedics taking on roles. So a real challenge in fundamentally redesigning what it is that we do. The big strategy message here is about how can we shift care closer to where people are and to make it much more person-centred. And so part of that is that we will see much more care delivered through primary care. So how we practically do that is a challenge. In NUCA, when they started off, I think they did two fundamental things. They started to think about how they can measure what it is that they were doing and how it was successful, but also how they could really genuinely engage and listen to the patient. So those two principles, measuring success and feedback and engaging with the patient or the customer, they call them customer owners because they really want to shift the relationship to make it clear that it's the patient who or the public who own the system. So systematic engagement, listening to feedback, acting on feedback is at the heart of the NUCA model, and I think that's where we're moving towards in Wales.